a friend sent me an apocalypse zombie box, so I considered we might well have to take a look inside. We'll discuss zombies in the first half of the video, and then I'll paint some of them in the second. Right, these are from the 5th edition. Some of them are primed or missing parts, while others are well painted. I'll try to select the best ones to show you. Now I'd be interested in stopping for a moment to consider the beginnings of zombies. The zombie quickly became a staple of horror films and a highly desirable monster as the medium progressed. Having said that, the zombies shown in White Zombie 1932, Revolt of the Zombies shown in 1936, and I Walked with a Zombie 1943 did not exhibit the traits of cannibalistic beings in the modern sense. Zombie people were actually people who had been cast a spell, namely the kind of enchantment that is common in voodoo and other magical traditions. In these movies, the terror of becoming a zombie takes center stage, rather than the actual dread of being killed by zombies, similar to their creation in Warhammer Fantasy. Zombies in this setting can only be brought back to life by a necromancer or magician's spell. Is not a virus, but rather an illness, much like the zombies you see in horror films and TV shows. Magic brought the dead back to life in Warhammer Fantasy, which was purely fantastical. I love the 5th edition miniatures as they look a little naive in comparison with the actual image we have of zombies in our actual visual pop culture. Even though they are scary, these zombies seem to come from a fairy tale story. If we take older editions of zombies in Warhammer Fantasy, we'll see that the aesthetic of the zombies is even more folkloric or apocryphal than the actual conception. In the Age of Sigmar, zombies undergo a fresh transformation. I find the Sublight Gravelord's army captivating due to its intriguing miniatures. However, I believe that although zombies possess a heightened level of realism, they lost their uniqueness because they are more similar to our contemporary idea of the zombie. those two miniatures will be mine to paint. As we can see, the corpses are a mix of Empire and zombies, with parts of both armies mixed throughout. Perhaps a city within the Empire had fallen to the undead.
Thank you.
Paint to the eyes may present a challenge, but there is no need to worry if you accidentally apply excess paint, as it can easily be corrected. In these cases, the surplus white paint will be concealed by applying contrasting paint precisely when I am emphasizing the under eye bag. IL Red is a beautiful variety of red that works nicely as a contrast. Nevertheless, I'd want to bring attention to some areas, so we're trying to blend it with another lighter red by applying very thin layers. Tafis Corrosion is great for zombie weapons, and I used it on certain steel parts since I adore the oxidation effect it produces. What you see in this glass container is caustic lime. I extracted it from a derelict home where some friends were working and ground it until it was extremely fine.